Welcome back, everybody. Tomorrow, there will be a citywide effort to get people to take time out of their busy day for a nap. Emily Underwood, Director of Development and Community Relations for I Understand, and Matt Young from Comfort Research are here to tell us about the event, Napportunity.
Napportunity.
And when we saw this, we said, yes, we want to be involved however we can. But tell us a little bit about the idea behind this event.
Sure. So Comfort Research has a wonderful mission, and theirs is to create products that help people be comfortable in their everyday lives. And that aligns well with our mission of helping to create support and compassionate comfort for families who have lost a loved one to suicide or struggle with mental illness. And so it's a wonderful way to raise money in a fun way where people can take a nap and take a break for their own mental health during the lunchtime downtown.
Yeah, we all need a break sometimes, right? Tell us a little bit about what this event is going to look like when you head downtown tomorrow to see this big event.
So hopefully not a total disaster. Hopefully the weather cooperates with us, but we're going to be out in Rosa Park circles, and we're going to have some of these chairs, which so Comfort Research is the manufacturer maker of the Big Joe chair. So you're sitting in a couple of Big Joe.
This is nice.
Comfy
Milano chairs. These awesome things are really soft and great to take a nap in. We've got some of our original Big Foof chairs. They're these huge, overstuffed, shredded foam beanbag style chairs. And we're just hoping that people take a couple minutes out of their day, because so for every bottom that hits a seat and takes a nap, we won't make you actually fall asleep. But if I do grab you by the collar and you're walking downtown and I throw you in a chair, maybe my methods are a little bit wrong. But we're hoping to raise $10,000 for this really awesome organization.
We're so excited. And we have other community partners that are going to be downtown too. So Meyer's bringing their food truck down there. We have other supportive organizations sharing information as well. So grab your brown bag lunch or grab to go and come and sit down and enjoy a couple minutes respite out of your busy day.
So he's hoping to raise $10,000. Where would that money go? How will it help?
That would be a huge sum of money that we're very thankful for the efforts to raise that money. So our mission is trifold. We provide compassionate comfort by providing care packages to families who've lost a loved one through our partnership with Helen DeVos Children's Hospital. Okay. We also fund the first of the kind in the country, clinical nurse specialist. And so that would help to support that mission as well. We have a monthly support group in collaboration with Fountain Street Church for families who have lost. That's a free, open to the community opportunity for those folks. And then we also have educational community awareness events. So all of our community events are free. Our educational opportunities are free. The care packages that we give out to families in need are free as well. And so fundraisers like this help to make sure those efforts are sustainable.
What a great cause. And we all need to do this for our own mental health, to be able to just relax and take time out of our day. I wish we could do that every day, don't you? If we could all get a nap every day.
Luckily, we've got more than one of these around our office, so we'll make sure that they have some too.
All right, well, we'll have all the information on this event that's happening tomorrow. It starts at what time?
I believe 10 o'clock.
11
o'clock.
Yeah, okay. We'll be there at 10, but officially 11 to 1.
11 to 1 downtown at Rosa Park Circle.
Yeah.
All right, you guys, thank you so much. And we'll have it all on our website at WZZM13.com. And we're hoping for good weather tomorrow, because we don't want these to get soggy, Aaron.
No, we don't. There's a slight chance for a shower, but bottom line, great napping weather today across West Michigan with...